Annyeong.
Hi, Kakka Korea.
Sayo, Maggie Boy. Today, we're gonna tell you how we met. So I'm a music producer slash DJ part time.
I'm ex cabin crew. We met 2018. We met in Zouk.
Zouk Club KL.
Yeah. But it's not how you think.
Actually, quite a weird the way we actually met. It was an event after another that happened. If that one particular event didn't happen, then all of it didn't happen.
Yeah, it started from It's the Ship.
So It's the Ship is actually like a music festival. As a DJ, I got to play there in the year 2018. And when I was DJing, a Korean DJ was actually watching my set, and his name is Jun Koko. So he came up to me and he said he really enjoyed the party that I was playing in. When I got back into Singapore, then I found out this guy had a song with Ailee, and I was freaking out. So I was like, dude, you have a track with Ailee. Ailee's my favorite singer, you know? That was no cool. It reminded me so much of my high school life, because in high school I was listening to Ailee a lot. Yeah. And then he said he's coming down to KL a few weeks after It's the Ship.
Okay, that's your story. Yeah. For me, Jun Koko, he is my best friend. He said that he met Malaysian DJs. He's really, really impressed how he played. I was also wondering who's that guy. But I didn't expect we will meet. He got chance to play in Zouk, so I just follow him, and then he invite you. So that's how we met.
Yeah. So after Zouk finished, the next day I met up with her and then Jun Koko as well. The following night or so, we did the same thing again.
Actually, you like me. That's why you follow, right? First impression.
First impressions.
You say love at first sight.
Okay, love at first sight. I don't think it was love at first sight. It was more like, interesting at first sight. Like, ooh.
You say that so many times, you love at first sight.
You tell me first, what's my first impression? Okay. You got so much to say, is it? Other than just, oh, tall, brown, cute, smile, that's it.
Okay, first impression. Let me tell you. Actually, I didn't think anything. Because you brought a Korean girl.
Oh, shout out Cathy. What's up, my best friend? Yeah.
She is my best friend now. But at first, he came to the Zouk with Korean girl. So I thought they are a couple.
You know why I brought her?
Why?
Because I was like, shit, this is, I'm meeting a Korean guy. What if we cannot communicate? Oh, I bring my other friend who's Korean. So my first impression is that I was wondering who was that girl wearing the white blouse. That was you.
Why? Why you wonder?
Because it's like, oh, she's kind of cool because she was standing like this. Me and my friends were like, ooh, yes. I was like intrigued to know who that was.
Yeah, but why?
Because she's pretty.
Oh, why? Yeah. The second day we went out together, we eat crab. That time, I saw you. You look very cute. Your eyes, your nose, your lip, like this is so cute.
That's a dumb reason.
Why it's so cute?
Because its eyes and nose very big. You should hang out with him.
The next day, we went to Sherabi.
I actually asked you out. I just said like, hey, you're in Malaysia. I'm in Malaysia. Let's hang out, you know? And you're like,
sure.
And my heart was like, yes. And then we went out on our first date.
It was in the
Plaza Pattaya.
Thai restaurant.
This was first week of December, I think. So here's the other thing I was worried about. I drove my mom's car when I was fetching them all over KL. Me meeting a foreign girl, but I don't know what are their relationship or dating expectations like. And I picked her up and I was like so shy because I had like my really shitty old Myvi. If it's past 2 o'clock, then a lot of cockroach. That kind of Myvi, you know. I thought she would judge me.
I don't even have a car. How can I judge you?
Yeah, I don't know.
How we like each other. When I was working for AirAsia, most of my flight was like early morning. I was on the way to airport like 4:30 like that. And then you texted me. You remember? You're saying like, oh, safe flight. Oh, you didn't sleep? And then you say that, oh, I woke up to text you or something, right? It was so cute. This guy sleep a lot. He can sleep whole day. Now I'm thinking, wow, actually he...
That was a big effort, man.
Yeah. But why you don't do anymore? Guys, the problem like that. When they really want that girl, they try their best. And after they get a girl, then change like that. No good, no good. I could see how you're trying. You're so nervous. Your voice also shaking. You are serious about it. I feel very appreciated.
But to be fair, I thought I had it under control. One of the reasons that attracted me the most was her laugh. After getting together with her, then I realized that she was actually a person who puts forth other people's feelings ahead of hers, which is something quite rare.
Push what?
Put forth other people's feelings before yours. So you care about my feelings more than...
Of course!
Knowing that, like, I'm a type of guy who does things and makes decisions based on what I feel in the moment, and I always get into a lot of trouble because of that. But having someone who cares about me and actually shows me why certain decisions are better than the others, that kind of reason is the one that actually made me really fall in love with her. That's why I couldn't let her go. Yeah. So yeah, it's a much deeper feeling.
Don't cry.
You always say I cry.
Mentioned that I decided to live in Malaysia because of him in my previous episode. For me, finding a lifetime partner also could be an achievement of life. I'm willing to take all the risk what I'm choosing for him. He's a kind of person work really hard to get what he wants. Find him for me is huge achievement of my life.
Same with her, like finding her was a big turning point in my life as well.
You're not the kind of guy who just say only. You make your word true.
With my own stuff?
Any stuff. Like our relationship or your thing, you know? Maybe it takes time, but you definitely do that for me and for yourself and then for us.
She's also the type of person who achieves what she wants to achieve. She said that she's gonna do YouTube, and when I look at her now, she really took those words and look where she is now. After only a few months of being on YouTube, which is quite a big achievement.
Good thing about our relationship is we believe in each other.
That makes up a very strong relationship.
Some of you might wonder whether my parents or his parents know about our relationship. Yeah. My family, relatives and all, we all know my mom loves him so much.
Yeah,
really. I mean, his family also quite often. Everyone take care of me because I'm here without any family. And his parents also say that, you know, you're like my daughter, which made me feel very touched. So what is our next plan?
So I guess we're just gonna be creating more mukbang videos, reactions and other different stupid content for you guys. So I hope you enjoyed the past two videos, which is how she lost her job. That's so bad. Don't enjoy that video. I hope you guys enjoy watching this video, finding out how we got together. And if you like this video and all of our videos, please like this video.
And subscribe.
Subscribe.
I see you in the next video.
Jumpa lagi. See you soon. This one's not recording.
What?
Oh man.
Really?